गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, सी द प्रॉब्लम, विल सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम टुडे विद कैश एंड बैंक कॉलम कैश बुक. एंटर द फॉलोइंग ट्रांजेक्शन्स इन द कैश बुक विद कैश एंड बैंक कॉलम्स, ऑल्सो पास जर्नल एंट्रीज वेयर नेसेसरी. एप्रिल 1st, कैश इन हैंड ₹6,200 एंड बैंक ओवर ड्राफ्ट ₹18,500. This is the negative balance of bank. 2nd April, received a check from Hari and paid it into bank on the same day, ₹1,300. 3rd, received a check from Vinod, ₹3,300. On 5th April, check received from Vinod deposited into bank. 5th April again, purchased goods and paid by check ₹20,000. Freight paid in cash ₹250. 6th, sold goods for cash ₹12,220. 8th, sold goods for cash ₹16,000. Sale proceeds of April 8th deposited into bank. 11th, withdrew cash for private use ₹1,000. 12th, withdrew by check for private use ₹5,000. 14th, goods purchased from Suresh on credit ₹2,500. 16th, paid to Suresh by check ₹2,500. 17th, received a check from Ajay, not banked, ₹3,700. 20th, check received from Ajay endorsed to Vijay. 22nd, received check from Mahesh and deposited into bank ₹2,700. 24th, received cash ₹1,000 and check ₹1,200 for cash sales. 25th, paid into bank ₹10,000. 26th, received a check from Prem and sent it to the bank immediately ₹4,150. 28th, bank notifies that Prem's check has been dishonored and bank charged ₹20 on this check. 28th, Kishore deposited directly in our bank account ₹3,000. And 30th April, bank has charged ₹60 for bank charges and interest on overdraft ₹720. So now we have to enter these transactions in cash book, and where necessary, we have to pass journal entries. So start now. So let's start now. We'll prepare double column cash book, that is two column cash book with cash and bank columns. Here, this is debit and this is credit side. And we will pass necessary journal entries here. Okay? Because they have asked us to pass journal entries where necessary. Okay? Let's start now. See the problem. Here in this problem, on April 1st, 2016, cash in hand is given 6,200 and bank overdraft, that is negative balance of bank, is given ₹18,500. So 2016, April 1st, two balance brought down. In cash column 6,200 and on April 1st buy balance brought down in bank column 18,500 as bank overdraft is given. Okay, next, on 2nd April received a check from Hari and paid into bank on the same day ₹1,300. So on 2nd April, we have received check from Hari and immediately deposited into bank. So to Hari's account, amount will be in bank column ₹1,300. Next, now 3rd, received a check from Vinod ₹3,300. This check has not been deposited into bank, so we will pass the journal entry in journal on April 3rd. received check from Vinod, so the entry will be check in hand account debit to Vinod's account. Check received but not deposited. Not deposited into bank. Okay. Now the next entry of the problem. On 5th, check received from Vinod deposited into bank. So receipt side bank column, on 5th to check in hand account, amount will be in bank column 3300 because check was of rupees 3300. Problem madhe tithe samor amount dileli nahiye, pan third la apan check miala 3300 rupayacha तो बँकेत भरला आहे असा त्याचा अर्थ आहे. 5th April अगेन परचेज गुड्स अँड पेड बाय चेक रुपीज 20,000 अँड फ्रेट पेड इन कॅश रुपीज 250. ॲज वी आर परचेज गुड्स वी आर गिविंग मनी, एंट्री विल बी ऑन पेमेंट साईड ऑन 5th April. बाय परचेसेस अकाउंट, ॲज द अमाऊंट was paid by check, amount will be in bank column. And now on the same date freight paid, so by freight account, freight paid in cash to, so amount will be in cash column dash in bank column. Okay. Now on 6th April, on 6th April sold goods for cash rupees 12,220. So on 6th April to sales account, sold goods for cash, so amount will be in cash column dash in bank column. On 8th April sold goods for cash rupees 16,000 again, so on 8th again to sales account 16,000 in cash column dash in bank column. 9th April, sales proceeds of April 8th deposited into bank, means rupees 16,000 were deposited into bank. This is a contra entry because on 9th we have to withdraw rupees 16,000 from cash column and deposit it into bank column, so we have to show the amount in bank column. Okay, so on 9th first we will withdraw rupees 16,000 from cash box, so by bank account contra entry, 16,000 we have withdrawn from cash and then now we will deposit it into bank to cash account contra entry in bank column 16,000. Okay, next entry. 11th, withdrew cash for private use rupees 1,000. So it is drawings of the owner by drawings account. Cash withdrew rupees 1,000. So cash column rupees 1,000 dash in bank column. Now on 12th, withdrew by check for private use rupees 5,000. Now the owner is withdrawing from the bank rupees 5,000 for private use. So again on 12th, by drawings account. Now amount will be in bank column because he is withdrawing the amount by check. That is, it means it is from bank. Okay. Now next entry. 14th. Goods purchased from Suresh on credit rupees 2,500. Goods purchased from Suresh on credit rupees 2,500. So this is the entry of credit purchase. which will go to the purchases book, but here they told us to pass the journal entries where necessary. So we will pass the journal entry for this transaction on April 14th. Purchase goods from Suresh, so entry will be as usual. Purchases account debit to Suresh's account. ही एंट्री नेहमी सब्सिडरी बुकमध्ये म्हणजे पर्चेसेस बुकमध्ये होते, पर्चेस बुकमध्ये. पण आत्ता आपल्याला या प्रॉब्लेममध्ये सगळ्याच एंट्रीज जिथे गरज आहे तिथे कॅशबुकमध्ये नसलेल्या अकाउंटच्या एंट्रीज पास करा असं सांगितलेलं आहे. सो वी आर पासिंग धीस जर्नल एंट्री. गुड्स परचेस्ड ऑन क्रेडिट. ओके, आपण आधीच्या प्रॉब्लेममध्ये पर्चेस किंवा सेलच्या क्रेडिट पर्चेस क्रेडिट सेलच्या एंट्रीज पास केलेल्या नव्हत्या, कारण तिथे आपल्याला जर्नल एंट्रीज विचारलेल्या नव्हत्या. त्यामुळे आपण रिलेटेड जर्नल एंट्रीज फक्त जर्नल प्रॉपरमध्ये वर्किंग नोट म्हणून पास केल्या होत्या, जस्ट फॉर बेटर अंडरस्टँडिंग. पण आपण इथे ही एंट्री जर्नलमध्ये केलेली आहे. नाव ऑन 16th पेड टू सुरेश बाय चेक ₹2,500. सो एंट्री ऑफ पेमेंट will be entered in the cash book. On 16th, paid to Suresh by check ₹2,500, so by Suresh's account ₹2,500 in bank column as payment was made by check. 17th, received a check from Ajay, not banked, ₹3,700. Now again we are receiving a check from Ajay, but we are not deposited that check into bank. So entry will be in journal proper. Check received from Ajay ₹3,700. So on 17th, check again, check in hand account debit ₹3,700 to Ajay's account ₹3,700. Okay, check received, but not deposited. Okay. Now the next entry of 20th. Check received from Ajay, endorsed to Vijay. Now here see this Ajay's check. आपण अजयकडनं चेक आपल्याला जो मिळालेला आहे that we have endorsed to Vijay. So entry will be passed in journal proper because this is not a cash transaction. So entry will be on 20th April, Vijay's account debit as check was endorsed to Vijay. Vijay's account debit ₹3,700 to check in hand account ₹3,700. Check endorsed to Vijay. To Vijay हे लिहिलं नाही तरी चालेल, कारण विजयलाच एंडॉर्स केलेलं आहे. विजय इज द रिसिवर, सो वी हॅव डेबिटेड, डेबिट द रिसिवर. So on 20th, we have endorsed this check to Vijay. Now next entry, 22nd, received a check from Mahesh and deposited into bank ₹2,700. So this entry will be in cash book. We have received a check from Mahesh and deposited into bank ₹2,700. 22nd, to Mahesh's account. As the check was deposited into bank, amount will be in bank column ₹2,700 and dash in cash column. Now 24th, received cash ₹1,000 and check ₹1,200 for cash sales. Okay, here it is not mentioned in the question that whether that check received was deposited into bank or not afterwards. So it will be assumed that check was deposited into bank on the same date. Okay. So entry will be on debit side on 24th, entries for sale, so two sales account. In cash column rupees 1000, in bank column rupees 1200. Now next entry, paid into bank rupees 10,000, means deposited into bank rupees 10,000. Now first we have to withdraw rupees 10,000 from cash box and then we will deposit that cash into bank. So this is a contra entry. First we will withdraw from cash rupees 10,000. So by bank account, withdraw rupees 10,000 from cash box. Cash box manna paise bahir gelet. Contra entry. And on the same day it will be deposited into bank, so two cash account, contra entry, in bank column rupees 10,000. Now 26th, received a check from Prem and sent it to the bank immediately. Again on 26th we have received a check from Prem, so two Prem's account, and as it was sent to the bank immediately, amount will be in bank column 4150. Now 28th, on 28th bank notifies that Prem's check has been dishonored and bank charged rupees 20 as bank charges. So dishonor entry will be on opposite side. So here on 28th by Prem's account, check dishonored. Okay, now the amount of the check is rupees 4150, but bank charged rupees 20, so that 20 rupees were also receivable from Prem. So amount in bank column will be 4150 plus 20, so 4170. Okay, now again on 28th, Kishore deposited directly in our bank account rupees 3000. So on 28th, to Kishore's account, directly in bank account amount deposited. So amount will be in bank column and dash in cash column. And now the last entry, on 30th April, bank has charged rupees 60 for bank charges. So on 30th, by bank charges, it means bank has deducted rupees 60 for bank charges from our account. Okay, and bank charged interest on overdraft rupees 720. So by interest on overdraft, in bank column rupees 720. Okay, so now we have completed posting every transaction and passing journal entries here. Now we will tally the double column cash book here. Let's tally first cash column, debit total, credit total, and then the difference, and then we will tally bank column, debit, credit, and difference. मी इथे तुम्हाला करून दाखवते, ते तुमच्या समजण्यासाठी आहे. You have to calculate this on rough page. So debit side cash column total, is 35,420. Okay, then credit total 27,250. So the difference is 8170. So 35,420. After deducting credit total balance is 8170. So 8170, this is the cash balance. Now bank balance, debit total. It is 41,650. Now credit total. $50,950. So here credit total is more and debit total is less. So there will be negative balance. So balance will be on this side. So difference 50,950 minus 41,650. Difference is 9,300. Okay. 50,950 is the credit total, which is the big amount. So 50,950 greater amount, it is 50,950. After deducting debit total 41,650, balance kami total asle bajula lihaycha hai. So difference will be here. Okay, dash here, dash here. On April 30th, that is the last day of April, by balance carried down 8170. On May 1st, two balance brought down 8170 dash in bank column. Now bank balance here on 30th, two balance carried down 9300. So opposite side on May 1st, buy balance brought down ₹9,300. सी इयर जस्ट लाइक दिस फर्स्ट एंट्री. इथेसुद्धा एप्रिलच्या आधीच्या महिन्यामध्ये म्हणजे मार्चमध्ये कॅश बॅलन्स ह्या बाजूला आणि बँक ओवरड्राफ्ट ह्या बाजूला आला होता. हा महिना संपला त्यावेळेलासुद्धा दे हॅव कॅश बॅलन्स ऑफ ₹8170 अँड बँक ओवरड्राफ्ट ऑफ ₹9300. ह्याच्यापुढे ते मेच्या एंट्रीज करतील. ओके, इन धिस वे याचप्रमाणे इथेसुद्धा बॅलन्सेस आलेले आहेत. अशा प्रकारे दर महिन्याचं कॅशबुक पुढे 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 केलं जातं. दिस इज द रफ वर्किंग इयर. मी तुम्हाला ते करून दाखवलं आहे कसा टॅली करायचा हे दाखवण्यासाठी. ओके, सो नाव सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लेम अकॉर्डिंगली इन युअर नोटबुक. दॅट्स ऑल.